What's up? I'm Matea Babcock. In this video, we're going to talk about how to have quiet hands as a rider. I feel like this is a very underrated topic. The more advanced you get, the more important this is. Recently, I had a cow clinic. This topic really was brought to life to me, and I remember the first cow clinic that I went to, I got in trouble a whole lot because my hand was up and I wasn't letting my horse have that choice, and I was micromanaging my horse. So it's a really a discipline with our hands as riders to get conscious and like just be aware of what our hands are doing, and then also to be intentional with our hands. When am I putting pressure on and when am I releasing? Is it in time with what I'm wanting to teach my horse? What I've seen a lot with students over the years is they're thinking one thing, they're thinking the right thing, but their body isn't in line with it. And that happens to everybody. Their hands will go up, get really high, or they'll just be really busy. If you're one of those people that talks with your hands, then this might be a challenge for you, because you'll try to talk with your reins like, we'll do this and we'll do that. And we don't mean any harm to our horse, but it is actually desensitizing them to the rein, which is not what we want. We want to have very intentional communication between that horse's mouth and our hand, and we want to respect it. We're in a very sensitive area of that horse's body, their mouth, so we want to respect that and honor that line of communication. So a couple tips I have for you on how to do this, because the hard part is if you're riding at home alone, you probably don't even notice when your hands are coming into play when you don't mean them to. So one of the first tips I can give you is try to keep your hand down in the mane. And one of the tricks that helped me was I would take a little piece of mane and I'd wrap it around my pinky, and I would keep my hand down in the mane. And if my hand came up, then I would kind of feel that mane slip out, and that would kind of trigger my brain to be like, oh, my hand is up, I need to put my hand back down. Because when I'm just riding around in general, I want to have my hand down in the mane. My hands shouldn't be up jiggling the reins when I'm not asking my horse for something specific. This also plays into your timing. Your timing will get better if you work on this. So say I'm asking for a four-quarter yield. If my timing is off and my hands are really busy, my horse will never find relief where I want them to. And what I mean by that is my horse won't know what the right answer is. So if I'm being very specific, my horse did something I didn't want them to, they didn't yield off my leg, I need to pick them up with the reins and then show them where to be, right? So if I'm doing a four-quarter yield, for example, my horse isn't yielding off that leg, I need to pick that horse up and get that shoulder over and then drop my hands to the mane, so that when my horse steps over, he gets that release of pressure and he's like, oh, that's what she was wanting this whole time. That's how you get your horse to connect the dots. That's why timing is so important in horsemanship. Another tip for keeping your hands down is, I really struggled with this in haunches in. Whatever reason, my right hand just did not want to do the right thing, you know? And so I have these little strings on my saddle. I would hold on to that so that when my hand tried to go up, it couldn't. You know, I'd be holding the rein and that. That's another tip to kind of not cheat. And that one works better if you are working on any kind of collected rein exercise. And you can obviously do this with both hands if you're really struggling. But teach yourself how to keep your hands down, keep them heavy down on that saddle. One last position that you may want to use, and I use this with greener horses, like colts, when I know I need to have a little bit of a shortened rein so that I have that control. And I also kind of need to hold on to the saddle horn because I'm not sure what they're going to do. I'll put my reins in a California roll, and then I'll hold on to the rein and the horn. And that's just another way you can do it. And then if I go to turn, I'll just take my left hand, pull out on the rein. If I have to go to the right, then my middle hand that is on the horn switches, and then to the right. So there's some ideas for you, no matter what level you're at, whether you're just starting out or you're trying to go one-handed or do some cow working. Those are some great strategies for keeping your hand down. My last tip that I'm going to give you is to film yourself or get somebody to watch you to tell you when your hands are coming up. That is like some of the best feedback you can get, because a lot of times we don't realize we're doing it. So the camera can be your best friend. Till next time, like and subscribe and share this video with a friend.